Every Thursday here on FTD Facts, we are always learning about a new plane, and we've talked about the F-35, the Sepcat Jaguar, and in my last episode, we looked at the Sukhoi Su-27. Today, however, we look at the Chengdu J-20, aka the Mighty Dragon. Yeah, that's right, guys, the Chinese fighter known as the Mighty Dragon. What a bad-ass name for a plane. I'm sorry, guys, you know, I know we love the F-35, it's a cool fighter, but that name... F-35 Lightning is just not as cool as the Mighty Dragon. You know what I mean? How's it going, everybody? My name is Dave Wapo. Welcome to our Thursday episodes here on FTD Facts, where I always look at new aircrafts from around the world. And if you like that sort of stuff, like the video and subscribe. And of course, check out our amazing playlist around the aircrafts. But today we are looking at the Chengdu J-20, just an amazing aircraft. So before I begin, I want to know, you guys are going to answer this in the poll up there. Which aircraft do you prefer, the F-35, the Chengdu J-20, or the F-22 Raptor? Let me know up there. And yeah, if you guys have a suggestion for another plane to do, leave it down here. It can be an old plane or a new plane. It doesn't really matter. So the Chengdu J-20, it's a new fighter. As a matter of fact, a new fighter on the block. Indeed, it's a fifth generation twin jet designed as a single seat stealth fighter. Now, the problem with this particular video and this aircraft is we don't know a lot about it compared to what some military experts might think. The truth be told, a lot of this stuff is, you know, top secret, so it's not out to the public. Let's be real. Would you want everybody to know your secrets? Probably not. This fighter obviously has been designed by the Chinese Chengdu Aerospace Company, and it evolved out of what was known as the JXX program, which started way back in the 1990s, also being called Project 718. Now, the first flight for this aircraft that we know of began on January 11th, 2011, and it was introduced to the Chinese Air Force on March 10th, 2017. And in today's world, it's classified as the third, fifth generation stealth fighter. Or more specifically, it's the second country, well, China's the second country to have a stealth fighter in the entire world. Sorry, Russia, I know you're trying, but you're not there yet. Now, here's the thing that a lot of people believe. For the Chengdu J-20, a lot of people believe that the technology for this aircraft was stolen from the F-22 and the F-35. Yeah. This theory began back in 2009 when the F-35's program had been compromised after a hack on the US servers, which the hack was traced back to China. On top of that, it's also widely believed that China and Russia had been working together on a stealth aspect since an F-117A Nighthawk was shot down in Yugoslavia in 1999. They believe that a lot of the parts from this aircraft went to China and Russia, and they began working on their own stealth and anti-stealth technology. However, it's really hard to say because, I mean, Russia and China both have a lot of anti-stealth stuff. At least that's what they're declaring they have. China has quantum radar, which apparently can detect F-22s and F-35s and the Grumman B-2 bomber. So that's a bit scary. However, moving along, getting into some of the details, there is about 8 prototypes that we know of with about 28 fighters out in the world today. Similar to the F-22 and the F-35, the Chengdu J-20 has bay doors that open to fire out its missiles or bombs. The reason for this is they want it to have a smooth surface so, you know, radar can bounce right off of it. And similar to the F-35, now I'm not sure about the F-22 if it's capable of doing this, but for the F-35, similar to that, the Chengdu J-20 can have external hardpoints. The Chengdu J-20 is said to be able to have 4 hardpoints carrying bombs or missiles on its wings. Now, currently, the only user of this aircraft is one country, and that is China. We don't know if any other countries are using it, but most, you know, experts are leaning towards, nah, it's just one country. We also don't know if other countries are interested in this fighter. That has not come to light just yet. Like most modern fighters today, they do have a touchpad and a major upgraded heads-up display and helmet. Like some versions of the F-35, it's said not to also feature an autocannon as standard. And when it comes to the stealth being stolen, there's another major indicator. If you look at the Chengdu J-20, if you look at the front nose of it, it looks very, very similar to an F-22. Just does. On top of that, some militaries like India have said they've been able to spot this aircraft on radar. Keep in mind that should be taken with a grain of salt because even F-35s and F-22s that use stealth technology and Grumman bombers, they have been known to have stealth reflectors on them to make them appear on radar. You might think that's a little bit counterintuitive, but the reason for that is to prevent any air accidents with civilians. And of course, you just don't want to be using stealth during peacetime. You know, you're kind of giving away your secrets. Now, it doesn't really matter if America is afraid of this aircraft or not, because let's be perfectly honest, in 2018, it was reported that America has their very own replica version of this. Now, don't know if that works very similar to a real Chengdu J-20, that's not been said, but we do know the American military has confirmed that they use it for training purposes. Now, one thing we do know about this aircraft, similar to an F-22 or an F-35, they're not really strongest in dogfighting. One of their biggest strengths is going up against Navy ships. They can slip in before they get detected, fire a missile, and get out before Navy ships even know what's going on. On top of that, it's also been said that this particular aircraft can carry more than an F-35 in terms of fuel, partially due to the fact that it is a bigger aircraft. But the one thing that we don't know, and this is the one that's been, you know, a lot of people have been saying this, again, it's not 100%, is the range on this aircraft. Some people have reported it can go 6,000 kilometers. That's insane. On top of that, it's said to go over Mach 2 and has a surface ceiling of 66,000 feet. To close it off, the final point is how much these things cost. Now, it's been said that the entire program cost came in at $4.4 billion. I find that hard to believe. Of course, reverse engineering makes things a little bit cheaper, but... But however, the one thing that is really fuzzy is the actual cost of an individual fighter. In 2001, it was said that it cost anywhere between $100 to $120 million. But in 2016, it was said that it's gone down to $30 to $50 million at its flyaway cost. However, that is a bare minimum cost. But to be perfectly honest, I don't think anybody, at least in the Western world, really has any idea how much these things actually cost. But there you go, guys. That is me looking at the Chengdu J-20. I know this video wasn't quite as in-depth as our other aircraft videos, but this is the information that we do know so far. Again, it's a new aircraft, so it's going to be top secret. But that's it. My name is Dave Wapple. Hope you guys like this video. Feel free to tune in every single Thursday and learn about new planes. That being said, if you have a recommendation for another plane, let me know down there. And don't forget to like our playlist and like this video. And before you guys get out of here, if you guys are into gaming or anything of that matter, you like some humor, some podcast, well, tune into my personal channel called Picky Nerds, where I do one video a week with two other guys. It's a lot of fun. But other than that, I'm Dave, and I'll see you guys later. Bye. All right, so here is the playlist on our aircrafts. Feel free to check it out. And yes, I hope you guys really like this video, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye.